From the discrete time Fourier transform, we saw that discrete time domain signal has periodic frequency domain, and we saw visually why this is true. And since each continuous time domain signal is a linear combination of continuous complex exponentials, then each discrete time signal is a linear combination of discrete complex exponential signals. The continuous time rectangular function is a linear combination of continuous time complex exponentials. The discrete time rectangular function is a linear combination of discrete time complex exponentials. Just from analogy, as we did in the previous videos, each point in the frequency domain corresponds to a complex exponential in time domain. The frequency and magnitude of the complex exponential is determined by the x and y values of the corresponding point in the frequency domain. But since here the frequency domain is periodic, then each point in the frequency domain corresponds to a discrete complex exponential in time domain. So each point in the periodic frequency domain represents a discrete time complex exponential. The magnitude and frequency of each complex exponential is determined by the frequency domain signal, which is given by the Fourier transform. The magnitude of each complex exponential is the value of the frequency domain signal at the corresponding point. The frequency of the complex exponential is the frequency at its corresponding point. Now we saw in the previous video that discrete time complex exponential has limited range of frequencies because of aliasing. It repeats itself each 2 pi of omega. For instance, if we have a discrete time complex exponential with omega equals to 0.2 times 2 pi, if we add 2 pi to omega, we should get the same signal. So the signal at omega equals to 0.2 times 2 pi is the same as at 1.2 times 2 pi, and 2.2 times 2 pi, 3.2 times 2 pi, and so on. So discrete time complex exponential signal has range of frequencies of width 2 pi. Any frequency outside that range has its own alias inside that range. The frequency domain signal is continuous and consisting of infinite number of points, and each point corresponds to a discrete complex exponential in time domain. Since the frequency domain is the summation of infinite points, the time domain is the summation of infinite discrete time complex exponentials. But the discrete time complex exponential has range of frequencies of width 2 pi. After that, the signals start to repeat over and over again. So we select a 2 pi interval in the frequency domain, which happens to be one period of the frequency domain signal. And we sum all the infinite discrete time complex exponential corresponds to the infinite points in that 2 pi interval. It seems to be redundant to take the whole range of frequencies into consideration. Each point outside the 2 pi interval has its own alias or equivalent in the interval. This is what the inverse discrete time Fourier transform formula is talking about. A definite integral of discrete time complex exponential whose limits are from minus pi to pi, or from 0 to 2 pi, any 2 pi interval in fact should work perfectly. Integral means infinite sum. Infinite sum of what? Infinite sum of all the discrete time complex exponentials associated with the infinite points constructing the frequency domain signal. Notice that the integral is scaled by 2 pi, meaning each discrete complex exponential in the summation is scaled by 2 pi. Here's another example in which the frequency domain is periodic sinc function with period of 2 pi. Periodic sinc function is also called Dirichlet function. Being periodic over 2 pi, then the corresponding time domain is discrete. To get the time domain, we take any 2 pi interval and sum all the discrete time complex exponentials in that interval. Here we chose the 2 pi interval to be from minus pi to pi, but we can use any 2 pi interval and still get the same result. Recall that each point in the periodic frequency domain represents a discrete time complex exponential signal. The magnitude of the complex exponential is the value of the function or the magnitude of the function at that point. And the frequency of the complex exponential is the frequency at that point. In each 2 pi interval, we have a sinc function, and the inverse Fourier transform of the sinc is the rectangular function. And since here the sinc function is periodic over 2 pi period, the inverse Fourier transform of it is a discrete rectangular function. The rectangular function and the sinc function form a Fourier transform pair. So discrete time signal is a linear combination of discrete time complex exponentials. Discrete time complex exponential has frequency range of width 2 pi. Any frequency outside the fundamental interval has its own alias or equivalent in the interval. A discrete time complex exponential sequence of frequency x is the same as if the frequency is x plus 2 pi. It repeats itself each 2 pi interval. Having a periodic frequency domain signal over 2 pi, then at each 2 pi interval, we have a set of discrete time complex exponentials, one for each point. The frequencies within each interval are equivalent to that of the fundamental interval as a result of aliasing. At the same time, the magnitudes within each interval are the same as that in the fundamental interval, since the pattern is repeating as a result of periodicity. So the inverse discrete time Fourier transform, or the summation of discrete time complex exponentials within each interval, gives the same time domain signal, discrete rectangular function. So discrete time Fourier transform takes discrete time domain signal to give the periodic frequency domain. Inverse discrete time Fourier transform takes the periodic frequency domain signal and give the associated discrete time 1. Inverse discrete time Fourier transform is telling us that any discrete time signal is a linear combination of discrete time complex exponentials. Their frequencies and magnitudes are determined by the frequency domain of the signal.